children, I am Radhika ma'am. How are you? I think you are fine. Today onwards, I am going to teach you the basics of maths from standard 3rd to 6th. Today's our topic is numbers. Here all we know about that, here normally we use the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9 and 0 to make the numbers. Hereby using these digits we can make the bigger smaller number to bigger number. Here example 2, it's a 1 digit number. 45 is a 2 digit number. 346, it has 3 digits, so it is a 3 digit number. Then 25,127. How many digits are here? 5 digits are here. So it is a 5 digit number. Okay. The next is comparing numbers. To compare the numbers, we can use 3 symbols. Here, less than, greater than and is equal to. Here these 3 symbols we are using to compare the numbers. Here example 24 and 9. Here 24 is a 2 digit number and 9 is a 1 digit number. Normally we know the 24 2 digit number is greater than 1 digit number. So here 24 is greater than the 9. Okay, another example, 46 and 89. Here both are 2 digit numbers. So first you write the first digit numbers. Here 4 and in this number 8. So which digit is greater here? 8 is greater than 4. Okay, so here we can use this symbol, means 4 is less than 8. So here the 46 is less than 89. The next is ascending order. Means if you get ascending order, means arrange the given numbers from smaller to bigger number. Here example 315, 310 and 319. Okay, how we can arrange these given numbers in ascending order? Normally we know ascending order means arrange the numbers from smaller number to bigger number. Here the smaller number is 310. So first you write 310, the next number is 315 and the last one is 319. We can see another example. Here it is 4 digit numbers. Here first number is 5,432, 7,869 and 1,999. How we can arrange these numbers in ascending order? Here, which is the smaller number here? 1,999 is the smaller number. So, we have to write first 1,999. The next number is 5,432 and the next one is 7,869. Okay, the next is descending order. Descending order means arrange the given numbers from greater to smaller. Here certain numbers are given. Here the numbers are 499 600 601 and 700. How we can arrange these numbers in ascending order? Here which is the bigger number among these numbers? 700. Okay, so first write 700, the next one is 601 and the last one is
start.
Another example is, second example, here some numbers are given here, 942, 994 and 9249. Here we can see the different digits numbers are here. Here 942 is 3 digit number, 9 is 1 digit number, 94 2 digit number, this number is 4 digit. Okay, here descending order means write the, arrange the given numbers from greater to smaller. So which is the greater number here? 9249. So first we have to write 9249. The next number is 942, 3 digit number. Then we have to write the 2 digit number, 94. And at last we have to write the number 9. The next topic is place value. Okay, place value refers to the value of each digit based on its position in a number. Here I will explain what is it. For example, 279. Here we know it is a 3 digit number. Okay, means I told you place value means the value of each digit based on its position in a number. Here the 9 is in unit place or ones place. Okay, and the 7 is in tens place, and this 2 is in hundreds place. Here the place value of 9 means here the 9 multiplied by 1 is equal to 9. That is the place value of 9. And what is the place value of 7? Here the 7 is in tens place. Okay, so the place value of 7 is here 7 tens are 70. Okay, then another number is, sorry, another digit is 2. The 2 is in hundreds place. So what is the place value of 2? Here 2 multiplied by the place value in which place stands. Okay, so 2 hundreds are 2 multiplied by 100. What is the answer? 200. Here the second example, the 4 digit number 7654. Okay, so we have to write the place value of each digit in this number. Here the 4 is in unit place, 5 is in tens place, 6 is in hundreds place, and the 7 is in thousands place. So what is the place value of 4? Is 4. And place value of 5 is, here the 5 is in tens place, so its place value is 50, and the third digit is 6. So the place value of 6 is, the 6 is in hundreds place, so its place value is 600, and the fourth digit is 7. This is in thousands place, so its place value is 7000. Here by checking this, means adding these place values, we will get the same number. Here 4 and here 5 6 7. So we got same number, the same number we got here. The next is successor and predecessor. It is a new word for the smaller children. Here the successor means after number and predecessor means before number. Okay, successor means after number and predecessor means before number. Then how we get successor? By adding 1 to the given number. Here example 247. Then how we will get the successor of this number? To add 1 to the given number. Then what is the answer? 248. So what is the successor of 247? 248. Another word is succeeding number. Okay, successor means after number or succeeding number. Then how we will get the successor? By adding 1 to the given number, we will get the successor or succeeding number. Then another one is predecessor or preceding number or before number. Then how we will get the predecessor? Subtracting 1 from the given number, we will get the predecessor. Example, the same number 247. Then how we will get the predecessor of this number? Subtract 1, minus 1. Okay, so what is the answer? 246. So 246 is the predecessor of 247. Here some more examples I will give you. Here I wrote one number 359. Here we have to write the predecessor of 359 and successor of 359. I told you before, here how we get the predecessor? Subtract 1 from the given number. Is 359 minus 1. Then what is the answer? 358. So predecessor of 359 is 358. Then how we get the successor? To add 1 to the given number. Then what is the answer? 360. So successor of 359 is 360. Another example, 721. So what is the predecessor of this number? 720 and successor is 722. Here now one more example. It's a 4-digit number, 1240. So what is the predecessor of this number? 1239 and successor is 1241. From this table we can write the middle number also. Here predecessor and successor is given is here, then here the number is 359. That is the middle number of 358 and 360. Okay, and the middle number of 720 and 722 is 721. And what is the middle number of 1239 and 1241? 1240 is the middle number. So we can write this is the middle number. Here the next is even and odd numbers. Here the first one is even numbers. Here the even numbers ending 2, 4, 6, 8 and 0. Okay, here example 10. Here the 10, the last digit, the last is 10, 0, so it is an even number. Here 28, here it's, this number ending 8, so 28 is an even number. And 96, here it's end with 6, so 96 is an also even number. And the second type is odd numbers. Here the odd numbers end in 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. Okay, here or we can use. Okay, here the odd numbers end in 1, 3, can write the example. Here examples for odd numbers. Here 13. Here 13 is an odd number. Is it the, this number ends in 3? Okay. And 79. 79 is an odd number. What is the reason? Here the this number ends in n by 9. Okay. Then 63. Here the 63 also an odd number. Okay. Here one question for you. Classify the given numbers into even and odd numbers. The numbers are given here. 148, 25, 32, 348, 87, 195, 796 and 553. Then to classify, first we have to make two columns, even numbers, another column, odd numbers. I explain how we can identify the even numbers and odd numbers. Here the numbers end with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0, then those numbers are even numbers, and the numbers end with 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9, those numbers are called odd numbers. Here first we can check the numbers one by one. The first number is 148. Here this number is end with 8. So 148 is an even number. So we can write in this column 148 in even numbers column. And we can check the next number, 25. Here the 5 is the last digit. So 25 is an odd number. Next one, 32. 32 is an even number. The next number again, 348. So 348 is an even number. The next is 87 is an odd number. Next number 195, odd number. 706, which type of number? Is an even number. And the last one is 553. It is an odd number. In today's class, we learned about the numbers, then comparison of numbers, ascending order. First one comparison, second one ascending and descending order. Third one, place value. And fourth one, predecessor. And successor. Last one, fifth one is even and odd numbers. I hope you all are understood. Thank you.